Well, the states and territories are under increasing pressure to come together and break the border closure deadlock amid a wave of criticism. Political reporter Fiona Whelan leads us off in Canberra. And Fi, what's the federal government saying this morning?
Well, Ali, look, there is a lot of frustration over this issue. This morning, the Home Affairs Minister has warned that if it doesn't get sorted out, many people on JobKeeper won't actually have jobs to go back to. And today in National Cabinet, the Prime Minister will be pushing the states and territories to reach an agreement on how borders are managed. Now, he wants a consistent set of national principles over interstate travel. This is particularly to resolve some of the special cases we're seeing, such as sick people who can't get medical treatment, people who can't get to work, farmers who can't reach their properties. Now, it's believed Queensland is likely to resist any move to loosen the rules. The Premier has indicated she won't budge. Here's Peter Dutton.
We just want an arrangement where people can get back to lives as we know it. And if we've got premiers who are pursuing an elimination process, the country will go broke.
There are single-digit active cases in Queensland right now. I mean, seriously, if any of us were sitting in Anastasia Palaszczuk's chair right now, would we be doing anything different?
Now, I should note that today's conversation isn't about reopening the borders. It's about working out how they can be better managed. But that chat about reopening shouldn't be too far off, Ali.
OK, thanks, V.
Doctors and nurses at Melbourne St Vincent's Hospital have sent out an SOS to healthcare workers across Australia and New Zealand.
If you're a nurse or a doctor who can spare a couple of months, we'd love you to join the St Vincent's team.
We'll cover all your flights and accommodation as well as salary.
Today, Melbourne reporter Christina Hearn is at St Vincent's Hospital for us this morning. Chris, good morning to you again. This comes after a big number of infections there.
That's right, Carl. I understand that 116 doctors and nurses here at St Vincent's Hospital have been infected with COVID-19 over a 2.5-month period. It's what's prompted that SOS video. I also understand that they have about 50 COVID-positive patients that they are currently treating in this hospital. I can also reveal that St Vincent's staff are currently actively being recruited to take part in a clinical trial to see whether hydroxychloroquine can prevent healthcare workers from contracting COVID-19 while they treat our coronavirus patients. Our hydroxychloroquine is a controversial drug. It was once taken and touted by Donald Trump, and our own national coronavirus task force has actually recommended that the drug not be used to treat or prevent the virus. But this 4-month trial is going ahead in conjunction with the Walter and Eliza Hall Institute. It will involve half the participants taking a placebo and the other half of the participants taking the controversial drug. They already have 40 participants here for the trial at St Vincent's Hospital. I can tell you the number of healthcare workers in Melbourne been infected with COVID-19 is an increasing problem. There are currently 753 active cases, putting an enormous strain on our hospital system. Carl.
Christine, thank you.
Residents in Brisbane and Ipswich are being urged to be on the lookout for COVID symptoms after a prison worker was diagnosed with the virus, sending the facility into lockdown. Today, Queensland reporter Jessica Millwood is in Wacol. Jess, good morning. You have some breaking news.
Alex, I do. We've just had confirmation from the Minister's office that this 77-year-old worker has returned a second positive test. So investigations into the source of where she contracted coronavirus, they do continue. She hasn't been interstate. She hasn't been overseas. So the fear is that it's somehow linked to those two Logan girls that came across the border from Victoria into Queensland. She worked 5 shifts here at the Brisbane Youth Detention Centre with symptoms. So now contact tracing is underway and the detention centre has gone into lockdown. There are people inside here as young as 13 and some of those will need testing. There will be no new admissions, no court appearances and no visitors for at least the next 2 weeks. Very soon, we're expecting a full list from Queensland Health as to exactly where this 77-year-old woman went while infectious. So we're expecting an update very soon. Alex?
Righto, Jess. Thank you.
The southeast coast is set to shiver through a weekend of wild weather, with temperatures set to dip 10 degrees below average. Today, Sydney reporter Gabrielle Boyle is in Richmond in Sydney's northwest. And Gabby, an Antarctic blast is bringing heavy snowfall to parts of New South Wales.
Yeah, that's right, Ali. I am swinging past the servo on my way home from work to pick up some firewood because it is going to be the perfect weekend for a fire, at least for the first half, before those really heavy winds kick in. Sydney is going to reach 16 degrees this weekend, but it will feel more like 9 degrees. And if you're in the ranges, the central tablelands, it will reach 5 degrees, but it will feel more like minus 3. Absolutely freezing. As you said, about 10 degrees below average, but it's those real winds that we're worried about, which will kick in over the second half of the weekend. And that will be winds of 90 kilometres an hour and gusts even stronger than that. That is going to have our SES very busy in some parts. It will be absolutely beautiful on our ski slopes. However, some of the levels there, Perisher 23 centimetres of snow set to fall, Threadbow 26, Falls Creek 20 centimetres and Mount Buller 21 centimetres. If you are lucky enough to have a lift pass this weekend, it is the perfect weekend to hit the slope, Sally.
Does sound good. Thanks, Gabby.
In breaking news, a man has been killed in a three-vehicle crash in the Sydney Airport tunnel this morning, the accident causing extensive delays. Two cars and a truck have collided before the M5 turnoff at Mascot. You can see cars are now banked up for kilometres. It's like a parking lot out there. Two of the three southbound lanes and one of the five citybound lanes are all closed. So if you can avoid that area, please try to this morning, even though that is difficult. Big, big delays in Sydney this morning. Also breaking right now, commuters in Brisbane are also facing delays of up to an hour on one of the city's busiest train lines. It comes as authorities work to remove a delivery truck, which somehow ended up on the tracks, blocking access to Manly Station. Services on the Cleveland line have been suspended, and a man in his 20s is being treated for minor injuries.
Russia's opposition leader is this morning fighting for his life in hospital with suspicions he may have been poisoned before getting on a flight to Moscow. A plane made an emergency landing in Siberia after Alexei Navalny began screaming in pain. His team suspects his cup of tea at the airport was laced with poison. Indeed, Joe Biden is right now preparing for the biggest political fight of his career, set to take to the stage in just hours in his third attempt to become President of the United States. The presidential nominee will deliver a speech in Delaware on the final day of the Democratic National Convention, pitching to Americans to vote Donald Trump out of office. The Duke and Duchess of Sussex have made their first appearance from their new California mansion, taking part in a video call with the Queen's Commonwealth Trust and a group of young leaders from Australia, America and Africa to discuss social media.
It takes a huge amount of courage for you guys to set up a community like you have, but then also for other people to stand up to hate, to stand up to disinformation, to stand up to lies.
You can either train people to be cruel or you can train people to be kind.
During the 30-minute call, Prince Harry also praised his grandmother for achieving her goals in the modern Commonwealth.
Sylvia
Jeffries.
Can you
train people?
Is that Sylvia Jeffries? Yeah,
I've been trying to train my husband for 13 years and it hasn't worked.
That's a really kind of sexist thing to say.
Why?
And I'm appalled.
It's legit, though.
Yeah.
Fair enough.